1986, the state of Nevada passed a law stating that sex education should be established in every single school district. And in this law, it stated it needed to be factual, fact-based. It needed to be able to address all the different specifics about sexuality, reproductive health, as well as sexually transmitted infections, and that it need to be taught by teachers who were really well versed in all of these subjects. In other words, it needed to be comprehensive. So I was sat on a committee in Washoe County starting in 1986 that established the sex education program here in Washoe County. It's called SHARE, Sexual Health and Responsibility. So they looked at ways that sex education was being taught all over the United States. Some was quite restricted, very few topics. Some were very comprehensive, taught everything. Some were abstinence-based. Some were much more rounded in the sense they actually talked about contraception. And out of all of those, this community group, because that's who we were, came together and said, we all have one thing we want. We do not want our children prematurely becoming parents, okay? And whatever that means to you, it means like before their time, basically. We don't want them getting pregnant. We don't want them getting HIV. We don't want them getting infected with sexually transmitted infections. So we believe that education is the answer. They need to know. They need to be able to know so they can take personal actions to protect themselves. Because you know you can tell your teenager many things, but the things they would take in or believe usually start a lot sooner than their adolescent years. So they trust you, they know you give them good information, they have lots of information. When they get to their teen years, they remember that and they can make good decisions. So that's part of comprehensive sexual education. Age appropriate. We started in fourth grade to make some definitions so that kids who were watching television, and it's amazing what you can see on and during daylight television now, would understand what words like intercourse meant. Many of the fourth grade activities involve parents so that they could talk to their children and begin to have dialogue about sexual issues. Fourth grade girls are maturing. That was a real important part. What's that like? Reproductive health. When you become mature, what does that look like? Boys, girls, and boys know about girls and girls know about boys. It was very comprehensive. It was all designed to keep kids so safe in the sense that they knew about making good decisions about their sexuality, their sexual health, and looking into the future, their abilities to be healthy for life. So comprehensive sex education throughout K through 12 is not just about intervening when they're that age. It's really about giving them a lifetime of information to help protect themselves, help understand about pregnancy. They use it for their lives. And so we felt it was very important to include things like definitions, to be able to talk about same-sex both sexual behaviors and same-sex marriages, to be able to define families in a new way so that all these kids felt like they were part of that educational process. We felt it was very important they understand about what the sexually transmitted infections were. I mean, we showed them pictures. They thought it was gross. They also were very interested. Sort of an interesting dichotomy, but that's that age. They were very interested in pregnancy, and they got to see a film with the birth of a baby. They thought that was wonderful. That's all part of a comprehensive sex education program. You want them to understand how they grow up, what sexuality is, how it might be expressed, how they can do it responsibly, how they can choose their own time, give them the skills to do that, and give them the knowledge to understand that what they're doing is really in their best interests.